Hey guys, welcome back. Let's go ahead and take a look at my next setup, which is basically setting up my certificate server, which is that server that I showed you in the previous lab over here, right here. This server down here, which plays an extremely important part in the whole setup. It'll do two things for me. Number one, it's going to act as my certificate server. Actually, three things. It's going to act as my certificate server. It's going to act as my WinSCP server for downloading or pushing down the certificates, the root certificates to the V edges later on, the WAN edges later on. I'll show you how to do that. And the last thing that I want to do over here is use it as an admin PC. So whenever I'm managing my devices, whether it's vManage, vSmart, or vBon, I'm going to be logged into this device to do that. All right? So what do I need to do on this device to bring it up to par so we can start doing our SD-WAN stuff? Let's take a look at that. The first thing when you do it, especially if you're doing it in Eve, the first thing that you need to do is give it IP addresses. So I'm going to have two interfaces over here. One interface on the inside, this is the outer band management interface. So this interface is 192.168.1. I'm going to use this as .1, .2, .3, and this I'm keeping as .5. And same on the outside, because I'm going to be communicating to the WAN edges to push down that certificate. I'm going to be on the 199.110 network. Again, .1, .2, .3, and this is .5 on that network. Remember, this is a /28 network. And my default gateway is going to be 199.1.1.14, which is the HQ router's inside interface. So let's go ahead and do that first. I've actually done that, but look at it. So this is the device over there. This is my first interface, E00. Go to properties, go to IPv4. This is the inside network, 192.168.1.5 and 255.255.255.0 over here. And then you have the other interface over here, which is, this is used by EVENGY to manage the device itself. That's the one that they RDP into. So don't use network 2. Use this guy over here, that is your outside interface, 199.115. Make sure it's /28. Make sure the default gateway is pointed to 199.1.1.14. So if this is okay, let's go ahead and do a test to make sure my outside network. Open up my command prompt over here, and I'll ping 199.1.1, let's say, not 199.1.1.1, I'll even go further out. I'll go to my 101.254, which is my MPLS router. So if I can go all the way over there, that means it's working. Or I can go to my internet router, which is 192.1.1.101.254. This is available now. So I just made a connection all the way here, this way, and I made it this way. All right? So that part of the server is done. The next thing that I need to take a look at is my application that I need to install, which is the certificate server. Let's go ahead and install that
over here and go back.
Oh, one more thing that I would do before I do that, and it's very important, time zones and times. So I need to make sure my time zone is correct, because before I install the certificate server over here, it does it based on a date and time. So before you do that in real life, make sure your date and time is synced up either with the NTP server or do it manually. In my case, I'm in the Abu Dhabi Muscat time zone plus 4 GMT, which is Dubai. Change the date and time. Today is the 7th of July, 10:18, which is the right time right now. Click OK. Click OK. That's the first thing that I will do, set the time zone. Now once I've done that, I'll go ahead and do the install.
Manager. That is done in the server.
This is my server manager over here. Go to the roles and add a role. The role that I want to add over here is this role called the Active Directory Certificate Services, the one that is highlighted. Check it, so you install that. It doesn't require it to have the web services, but it'll do it as part of the install. So Active Directory Certificate Server, click Next. Next, it says, okay, this is what's going to be installed. I also want my clients to register through the web, so click on that, and it will enable the web server for you. Add the required role, so those are the two services that I need. Click Next. And just keep on going, doing the normal next command to let it install it. Click install, and let it go through the installation. Once it comes up, it will be good to go. Let it finish. While it's finishing, what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the next couple of things that I need to do. The next thing that I need to do is install this service called the WinSCP service. I have the file loaded up over here into my downloads folder, but I haven't installed it. So I'm going to install that. Again, another setup. While the other setup is going on, I can go through the setup of my WinSCP, which is going to be used as my program to transfer the file into the WAN edges. What file am I going to transfer? Later on in the videos, you're going to see that I'm going to be downloading the root certificate down there. Install it, accept, next, 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 and install the normal installation. Done. I'm not going to launch it or anything like that. Just keep it like this and finish it up. So that is also installed. In the meantime, this installation has also succeeded. So what are the different things that I did over here just to recap? On the certificate server, number one, I set the IP addresses properly or verified them. Interface IPs. Number two, I changed or set the time zone. Set the time and time zone over here. Number three, I install the certificate services with web enrollment. Very important because that is required for you to do that. And I install the WinSCP application, which is going to be used for my downloading of my root certificate. Let's go ahead and take a look at that in terms of the lab workbook. Have we accomplished all the time? So the Ethernet interface is over here. Configure the time zone. Install the enterprise root certificate, which we did. And the fourth one was install the WinSCP. So at this point, I have actually finished my non-SD-WAN components. Now that I've done that, I've set my topology up, my base, so that I can go ahead and implement my SD-WAN components. We're going to start with the vManage and move down. Again, when we do that, we have two components that we need to do in terms of configurations. We need to do the CLI config to skinny up the device so that I can manage it from GUI and then register inside the GUI. We'll take a look at that in the next section over here, which is the controller bring up. All right, do join us for that.